Hi everyone, welcome to Exploring 19 TET. In this video, I'll talk about scales and their structures more generally. Let's start with the diatonic major scale. There are a few properties it has which make it particularly well suited for building harmony. It has fairly consistent step sizes. It has many consonant chords. But one very interesting thing about the major scale is that if you transpose it up a fifth, a single note changes. This is the basis for the circle of fifths, which governs how different keys relate to each other. The fact that the diatonic scale has this property is one of the earliest taught pieces of music theory, but it's not immediately clear why it should be true. Of course, you can verify it by counting out semitones, but that won't give you a satisfying explanation. For a better understanding, let's look at how the scale is constructed. If you start from F and stack six perfect fifths above it, you'll get the full C major scale. If you transpose this scale up a fifth, it's clear why a single note gets raised. If you transpose it up a fourth, that is, down a fifth, it's clear why a single note gets lowered. This construction also clarifies how the scale's modes relate to each other. The chain of fifths organizes the modes from brightest to darkest. Notice that in brighter modes, the tonic has more fifths stacked above it, while in darker modes, the tonic has more fourths stacked above it. This is one reason that people say fifths are inherently bright and fourths are inherently dark. This idea can be useful, though I don't think it works in all contexts. Sometimes thinking of brightness in this way can help analyze chord voicings or modulations. So what does all of this have to do with tuning? Well, since the perfect fifths are stacked on top of each other, a small change in how the fifth is tuned adds to itself as you go up the chain. Let's look at the scale's other intervals. You get a major third in this scale by stacking four fifths. If you tune those fifths to the just ratio 3:2, the major third will have the ratio 81:64. That's significantly sharper than 5:4, the just ratio of the major third. If the fifth is tuned a bit flatter than just, the major third will improve. 12 tets fifth is only 2 cents flat, so the major third is still somewhat sharp. 19 tets fifth is 7 cents flat. That makes the major third slightly flat as well, though the major sixth is close to perfect. This slight change in the fifth matters more the further you go along the chain. The difference between F and F sharp in augmented unison is quite a bit smaller than it is in 12 tet. In a sense, this means the change in brightness from moving a step along the circle of fifths is directly reduced. I like to think of this as the circle of fifths having finer gradations of brightness. 19 tets slightly flatter fifth also makes the diatonic semitone wider. I feel like this change loosens up the major scale, reducing the distance of different scale degrees. Because there isn't as much dissonance in the diatonic scale, straight functional harmony may not work as well. On the other hand, having less dissonance means complex chords can be easier to justify. The effect the tuning of the fifth has in 19 tet is pretty subtle. In some other tunings, the difference is more pronounced. Take a look at 22 tet. 22 tet has a good fifth and a good major third, but since the fifth is somewhat sharp, 4 fifths stack to a super major third, not a major third. If you construct the major scale in 22 tet by stacking fifths, the scale's triads won't be the consonant ones you would expect. Some scales just don't work as well or at all in some tunings. Looking at how this scale construction works or doesn't work in different tunings, you may wonder which scales 12 tet doesn't support, which could work in 19 tet. To find out, let's look more closely at the structure of 12 tet. The major scale is built by stacking perfect fifths, but could you stack a different interval? You can, but a problem arises. 12 has a lot of factors, so it turns out that every interval except for the fifth and fourth just stacks to the octave, so you can't make a circle like the circle of fifths. Symmetrical scales are interesting in their own right, but they aren't what I'm talking about right now. So what about 19 tet? Once again, what's important is that 19 is prime. You can stack any interval you want to make a scale. Not every scale you can make this way will be very good, though. Major or minor thirds don't hit the octave anymore, but they only miss it by one step. If you keep stacking, you'll get clusters of adjacent notes, which usually aren't good for scale structure. You could make a 7-note scale by stacking major seconds, though it won't have any perfect fifths. but one very good option is to stack sub-minor sevenths. Doing this gives you a 9-tone scale with some very interesting uses. I'll talk about that scale in the next video.